It's hard to believe, but it's been nearly 9 years since I first made the decision to cut the cord. And here we are so many years later, and I still get questions from people about doing the same. Now, over the years, we've seen an influx of some really great streaming apps, but the only downside to most of those is that they're paid subscriptions. What people really want to know is, are there free alternatives out there? Well, the good news is, yes, there are. And on this episode, I'm going to share with you some of the ones that I think are best.
Never forced, never coerced. Open discussions about things in life that matter to you most. From tech to TV, movies, and gaming, and everything in between. Welcome to Voluntary Input.
Welcome to Voluntary Input. Now, if this is your first time tuning in, I want to welcome you and thank you for checking us out. And if you would, go ahead and consider just checking out some of the past episodes, and I hope you find something that you enjoy. And I hope that you consider sticking around by just hitting the subscribe button from wherever you're listening or watching. So, for example, if you're listening on Apple Podcasts, go ahead and hit subscribe and leave us a 5-star review because we think we deserve it. Okay, I'm just joking. No, but seriously, if you would consider just leaving us a review, because the more you review our show, the more it keeps us on the relevant page of the podcast app, and that helps us out a lot. And that's true if you're listening to us on Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Amazon, because we are available on all of those platforms. Now, if you want to know more about Voluntary Input, just go to voluntaryinput.com. There you can find all the different places you can listen to us. You can find all of our past shows, past videos. And while you're there, go ahead and hit subscribe on the website itself, because when you do that, you will be notified of new content. And we're going to have some special content coming later down the pipe, and you're going to have to be subscribed to get it. All right. And also, before I forget, while you're there at voluntaryinput.com, go ahead and select that little donate button there at the top, because you will find there our Patreon page, where if you become a patron of Voluntary Input, you can score yourself some sweet Voluntary Input merch. Or you can go ahead and hit buy us a coffee. You can buy us a one-time coffee, or you can give us a recurring donation. Because here's the thing, guys. Every little bit that you give to the show goes right back into the show. And it helps us out immensely. It helps us continue to bring you this great content and continue to build the show out to become the best that we think it can be. All right? All right, let's go ahead and dive on in. The website decisiondata.org, the average cable bill now exceeds all other household utility bills combined. So it is no surprise that people are trying to think of more and better ways to get rid of cable. I mean, if you look at this, the average household cable package is now $217.42 per month. The average household spends $205.50 per month on all major utilities combined: electricity, gas, water, sewage, garbage. The average household cable package cost continues to increase year over year. So it comes as no surprise to anyone, especially me, that there's people always trying to look for better ways. What are better ways to just watch TV? Because let's just face it, that's the bottom line. We just want to watch TV. We want to be entertained, and we don't want to have to spend an arm and a leg for it. So the first thing I always tell people whenever I'm asked this question is, first and foremost, get yourself an antenna. Now, there are some indoor HD antennas. They come in varieties of shapes and sizes and packages. They usually have, a lot of them usually have a little preamp that comes with it, which is good to help boost the signal. But I also tell people, if you want the best performance from your live over the air local channels, you want to get yourself an attic and or outdoor antenna. These are always going to be the best. I have an antenna in our attic, and with it, I get 68 at the last time I counted. I think it's 68 over the air HD channels. Now, one thing that's surprising about that, when you first hook it up, you will notice, as I did when I first did it years ago, that all of the channels that you get, they look 10 times better than they did coming through your cable box. And the reason for that is, with the cable box, there's a lot of compression that goes on, because you got to remember, they're trying to fit in packages of channels coming through a box through the cable to you, as well as hundreds of thousands of other people. So although their picture quality is good, it is actually compressed. The over-the-air signal is cleaner, crisper, and it just looks, best way to put it, it just looks 100% better. Now, that being said, once you get that antenna, that's it. All of those channels are free, because in 2006, the federal government mandated that all of the local over-the-air channels have to go to HD. Now, there's a lot involved with that. You know, I don't know if you guys understand this, but the government actually basically, quote unquote, owns these different frequencies of airwaves, and they tend to auction them off, shuffle them around, or whatnot, primarily for communication purposes, where, you know, whereas it comes to military applications. Okay, so that all being said, in 2006, they mandated that all these channels have to go to HD. They have to be on that spectrum of the broadcast signal, which is great for consumers, especially if you're just going to use an antenna. Now, some people stop at that. That's good enough for them. Believe it or not, I have talked to people who said, you know, I just want to get rid of cable. I'm tired of paying for television. I don't even care about Netflix and all that. I don't even care about Hulu. What do I need to do? And they get the antenna and they're satisfied with that. And guess what? Lo and behold, they pay $0 a month for television because they're using an antenna. Now, that's the first step. Now, if you still want to go a step further and you still want to stream channels, there's one more important thing that you have to remember, which, in my opinion, is very unfortunate, very unfair, and I have a lot of negative opinions about all of this. However, when you decide to drop your cable and you tell your cable company, you know what, I just want internet, the price that you're going to pay for internet is going to skyrocket. And it's ridiculous. It's absolutely atrocious that they get to get away with this. So, for example, if you just want a basic internet, let's say 200 megabytes per second down, if you want the 200 Mbps package, you could expect to pay at least $80 a month for that. And that's absolutely ridiculous. But in either case, it's kind of like the cable company is punishing you for getting rid of the countless channels that you don't want, in which you are giving them, like I said, that national average of $217.42 a month. All right. But, you know, I digress. That's another whole topic. I've covered that before. I've talked about it before, and I may follow up with it, follow up on it at a later date. So anyway, the question is, you know, okay, so let's say you want some streaming channels. There's always the good old standbys. There's the Netflix, there's the Hulus. Now we got Disney Plus, we have Paramount Plus, we have Discovery Plus. We have all these different channels coming out now, these different streaming channels, HBO Max and so on and so forth. Now, if you start getting those, you will notice that your bills that you're paying monthly will quickly rack back up to the point where you might as well just go back to cable. Now, a lot of people will say, and I tend to be in this camp, that this is kind of what was wanted from the beginning. Once the networks and the cable companies figure it out, well, people are going to drop cable. What are we going to do next? How can we recoup those dollars? Well, they splintered everything off. They made everything a la carte, which is kind of what we wanted in the beginning to begin with. We didn't want to pay for cable for these bundles of channels, which, you know, there were a lot of channels included that we didn't want anyway, right? So they quote unquote did what we wanted. They broke everything up. Unfortunately, at the same time, they're essentially nickel and diming you to death for each subsequent streaming channel, just so you can watch TV, right? So it takes us back to square one. The original question is, well, what Are there, you know, are there free alternatives to all this? Yes, there are. And there's some great ones out there too, I'm glad to tell you. But I do want to preface this with a couple other things before I jump into the things I'm about to share with you. First and foremost, always remember simply this: nothing is free. So the channels I'm going to talk to you about tonight, although they are free, believe it or not, that content has to be paid for in some way or another, right? How do you think they're going to pay for that content? You probably guessed it: advertising. So if you're going to watch these streaming services for free, you're going to have to be willing to tolerate what some people consider basically the devils of television: commercials. Now, if you could put up with commercials like I can, I grew up on commercials. As a matter of fact, even to this day, I still say some of the best stuff on television are some of the commercials. If commercials are not a big deal to you, what I'm going to talk to you about tonight, you're golden. You're already set. If you're already willing to be able to tolerate commercials, if they're not that big of a deal to you, great. You're already on the right path. Now, secondly, some of these channels, these free channels with the commercials, they're going to offer you some content that may not be the quote unquote popular new hot shows. And you may get some channels that you're like, I don't even know what this is. I've never heard of it before, but it's intriguing anyway. And you're going to look into it anyway, right? So there's a trade-off there. You may want to consider that, yes, I'm getting this stuff for free. A lot of it is stuff that I may not have heard of. And my new show that I love on such and such big network isn't included. But here's the thing. If you want free and you just want entertainment, I'm telling you, the channels I'm about to show you tonight are absolutely superb for that. If you're just looking for some great new entertainment for free, remember, that is the goal here, free, then you are going to love what I'm going to tell you about tonight. Now, you may have heard of some of these things, and if you have, that's great. And hopefully you'll jump on board after I tell you more about them. Now, the first one I'm going to talk about has been around for a while, and it has gone through a few metamorphoses, and that's Tubi. In my opinion, Tubi is one of the greats. Now, again, the thing about Tubi is you can either set up an account or you can watch as a guest. Now, the thing is, the experience is literally the same. You're going to get all of these great movies, shows, and whatnot for free. The only caveat is Tubi shows commercials. That's how they pay for the content. One of the reasons why I love Tubi is because they offer a lot of great newer content. So if you look in like this horror category, they have things like Orphan, The Hills Have Eyes, Jeepers Creepers, some of the newer, not brand new, but newer and up to date. They have the original Candyman. And then you get into like TV shows. They have Heartland out of Canada. They also offer some news outlets. There's NBC, there's Live Now from Fox, and so on and so forth. They even offer some local news streaming channels. There's Fubi Sports or Tubi Sports, and so on and so forth. Now, one other thing that I love about Tubi is if you go to their browse section and if you go by category, you will find some great, great content. And it's just thousands upon thousands upon thousands of contents available. There's anime, there's comedy, there's documentary, there's horror, my favorite. They even offer some great British sitcom and so on and so forth. And they, like I said, they offer some great network content from A&E, Lifetime, and so on and so forth. Again, for free, which is, without question, the greatest price, right? free content. But again, all you have to do is be willing to watch commercials. Another great thing about Tubi and their commercials is when they're up against the commercial, when they're about to show you a commercial, at the top of the screen, there's a little bar that'll come up and tell you that an ad is about to start. The commercials are about to start, and they're usually, you know, they're usually just a few seconds long. And they, like I said, they tell you that they're coming, and that makes it perfect. Hold on a second. I had some little background audio playing from Tubi, as a matter of fact, because I had accidentally clicked on a show. But anyway, they will tell you that they're about to start showing commercials. There's usually about three or four commercials. And, you know, it's just the typical average length of commercial time that you're used to when you're watching just live over the air television. Again, that's Tubi. It, in my opinion, is probably at the top of the pile of all of them. Now, of course, I would be remiss if I didn't mention one of the pioneers of this structure, and that would be Crackle. Now, Crackle, over the years, they had some shaky, you know, they went through some shaky ground, but they finally got bought out by Sony, and Sony put some great polish on Crackle, and it's only been getting better and better and better. I've told people about Crackle before. I've written a blog post about Crackle. You can go check it out. You can go to my website, my personal website, leojallenjr.com. Click on the cord cutting tab, and there you'll find all of my tips and tricks about cord cutting. You can even find my original series about the truth about cutting the cord when I did it many, many years ago. But like I said, the thing about Crackle, just like Tubi, they offer you great content, like they have Django Unchained, Mr. Church, all kinds of great content. But remember, while you're watching this stuff, you're going to get interrupted by commercials. Now, years ago, when Crackle was first getting their footing, their commercial breaks were horrible. They would just drop in at the worst time, sometimes mid-sentence when someone's in the middle of some dialogue, and it was absolutely atrocious. They slowly got better and better at it, and then once Sony took over, they've gotten even that much better at it. So now when you're watching shows, now unlike Tubi, they don't give you that little heads up that a commercial is about to start. They just kind of come in, you know, and to me, that's kind of more like traditional television, if you would. You know, you're just sitting around watching TV and then a commercial breaks in. You can kind of tell when it's coming. And again, just like Tubi, they have different categories. They have television shows and they have movies. You can search. And again, you're going to get some great content. Some of it you may not even know, but to me, that's the beauty of it, because there's so much stuff out there today for entertainment that you're going to have literally an endless library of choices just between Tubi and Crackle alone. And then, of course, next, there is also the great juggernaut who's been around for some time now, good old Pluto TV. Now, Pluto, they were a surprise. I signed up for Pluto, it was a few years ago. Now, the way they lay their layout is, you get this TV guide type experience where when you first log in or you first get on Pluto, you'll notice there is just this basic guide, and there's already live content playing. Now, again, the thing about Pluto is they are more kind of like they're trying to aim like being more of your traditional type TV. You know, you're just scrolling down, you're looking at the guide and you're picking channels. It's not necessarily on demand stuff. They do have on demand content, but for the most part, their experience that they're giving to you is they're giving you the live channels as the live channels are broadcasting. And the thing is, once again, you're going to come across a lot of things that you've never heard of, a lot of channels you never heard of. But again, That's part of the discovery of finding some great new content. Now, it may not be the newest, hottest, most popular content, but oftentimes you are going to find some things that just absolutely surprise you. I know I have. Now, they break things up in categories like the others. They've got crime, comedy, classic TV, home DIY, and so on and so forth. They do offer on-demand content as well. And another great thing about Pluto is when you create your Pluto account, based on where you are geographically, they also can include some of your local channels. So for me personally, I get a couple PBS channels, my local PBS affiliates. I get, I believe it's two of my local ABC channels and my local Fox affiliate channel. So, and the results vary. You may get more or you may get less, but you know, they do their best to get your local, you have some local live streams on there too. And they're not just the on-demand versions of your local affiliates. For example, we have a local ABC affiliate. They have their own streaming app, but if you are familiar with those local affiliate streaming apps, it's only the local news. So they can't show you like the content that your regular ABC is showing later on in the evening. The thing with Pluto, like I said, once again, they're showing you what the channel is showing at the time. And the way they accomplish this, again, through commercials, through advertising. But like I said, once again, it's free. This is free content, folks. You don't have to pay for it at all. $0, $0. Okay. And lastly, there's one that I always, always, always try to tell everyone not to forget. Don't ever, ever forget your local library. Now, am I talking about going to the library and renting videos? Absolutely not. You're going to want to check with your local library about this awesomeness, Canopy. I personally love Canopy. Now, here's the thing. Based on your library, hopefully you can get this. You create an account using your library membership. I'm a member. My family, you know, we're members of our local library. Canopy, the amount of content that is available on this streaming service is just astronomical. You get documentaries, you get kids content, you get all sorts of content. Lots of stuff that, like I said, you're going to discover a treasure trove of movies and things that you never heard of. And it's absolutely beautiful. They even have an Amy Winehouse documentary. And there's, I just can't speak highly enough of it. There's so much on Canopy that I don't think you could ever consume it. And all of this is thanks to partnerships with libraries across the country. Essentially, they are presenting to you an entire catalog of entertainment that's available to libraries pretty much everywhere. And folks, let me tell you, it is a lot. And again, it's free. Free. The favorite cost of everything, right? All right. So to recap, again, you can still cut the cord and essentially pay nothing for television. You're going to pay internet. And like I said, unfortunately, it kind of frustrates me that no one's talking about this. No legislatures talk about it. No one talks about the fact that if you get rid of cable, how your cable company, your ISP is allowed to essentially triple your internet access, the cost of your internet access, just because you won't buy their cable bundles. That to me is absolutely criminal. But again, like I said, that's another whole topic of discussion. But again, if you want to get rid of that average of $217 a month for cable, but you still want to watch some great content. It may not always be the newest, hottest content. It may be some slightly obscure content, but if you just want entertainment, these are, in my opinion, your best options. So what you're going to want to do, like I said, just go ahead, hop online, get yourself Pluto TV, Tubi, Crackle, and Canopy. And like I said, don't forget to get that antenna. If you have to get one of those indoor HD antennas, those are fine as well. But again, I would actually encourage you, if you can, if it is at all possible, get yourself an antenna either in your attic, if you have an attic, or on your roof, or outside somewhere, because you're going to get the best reception the higher up you are. And sometimes with your antenna, you're going to have to experiment a little bit, because believe it or not, depending on the direction you face it, you're going to either get more channels or get more stable signal based on that. You know, for those who are old enough like me who remember, that's how TV started. That's how it started. You had to get an antenna, you had to position it right, or you had to have a great antenna and whatnot and so forth. So again, folks, you do not have to pay an arm and a leg. You don't have to pay $217 a month to get some great entertainment on your television. Now, if you have any questions or comments about any of this, just go to voluntaryinput.com and select contact. I would love to reach out to you. You know, we have no problem talking to you. And hey, if you want some more tips and tricks, again, go to voluntaryinput.com and select contact, and we'll reach out to you and we'll help you right along with it. All right. Again, guys, enjoy you some entertainment for free. Go ahead and cut that cord. Don't be scared. Now, real quick, this is worth mentioning because this always comes up. What about sports? Well, a lot of your local over-the-air channels will show you, as you guys know, you can get a lot of football games. You can get some baseball games. If you're into soccer, you can get those as well. But here's the thing. Those leagues, they have their own streaming apps. And again, that's another episode and another conversation. MLB has their own. NFL has their own, and if I'm not mistaken, MLS has their own as well. If you absolutely have to have sports, you're going to have to look into those, and I'm going to tell you they're going to cost you. And in the case of at least one of them, and I don't want to rag on them again because we've ragged on them before, in the case of at least one of them, it's not worth it, in my opinion, especially for what you are going to want to watch, because you're not going to get to watch it anyway. Anyway, this episode was about how can you get some great entertainment for free. So again, go to Pluto, go to Tubi, go to Crackle, and never, ever, ever forget Canopy. All right, guys, thanks a lot for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next one.